Talking Transportation, T-Talk Videos on Transportation TV. Elaine Chao is the U.S. Secretary of Transportation. Speaking at the Transportation Research Board conference in Washington, D.C., Chao revealed that USDOT is taking steps to make some major decisions about proposed regulations on the use of drone technology and new guidance on the government's approach to autonomous vehicles. Chao's speech, titled Our Transportation Future, presented an overview of the department's actions in support of her priorities of promoting safety and innovation while improving transportation infrastructure. This video contains Chao's remarks delivered January 14, 2019, in their entirety.
Hi, everyone. Thank you all so much for being here. During this particular time, there was some consideration as to whether we should hold this at all. But because of the importance of this conference and also the many, many attendees and participants who view this as a very important annual event, we have decided to go ahead with it. And I want to thank Brandy Hendrickson, who is the Federal Highway Administrator, for being here. And Brandy's around here someplace. And I also see that we have Mike Lauder. Mike was the former director of S60. He has retired, but I want to say how much we appreciate his service. I'm delighted that he is here as well. Now, I can go on and talk. Oh, there's Brandy over there. Let's give Brandy a great round of applause. Well, I'm really pleased to be here, as I mentioned, to update you on the department's innovation agenda and also share some exciting news about drones, autonomous vehicles, and also commercial space. There is no doubt that this is one of the most exciting eras in transportation history. New technologies are being developed that have the potential to save lives, revolutionize travel and commerce, and provide new mobility options for underserved communities. Some of these technologies are still in the early phases of development. Fully autonomous or self-driving vehicles, for example, exist primarily in limited and controlled circumstances. They're not yet quite fully available in the marketplace. Drones, however, are well on their way to mainstream deployment. They're mostly used by hobbyists, by first responders and rescue and recovery efforts, and also to inspect infrastructure. In fact, as of December 14, 2018, there were nearly 1.3 million registered drones in this country, and more than 116,000 registered drone operators. And commercial space, which was once the realm of science fiction, is now a reality. Just 5 years ago, the United States lagged behind Russia, Europe, and China in commercial space operations and launches. Beginning in 2017, however, the United States became number one in commercial space launches and maintained that lead in 2018. In this administration, the department's approach to new transportation technologies is performance-based rather than being highly prescriptive. We are not in the business of picking technology winners or losers. Our philosophy is to encourage the widest possible development of safe, let me emphasize, safe new transportation technologies so consumers and communities can choose for themselves the mix of options that suits them best. Now, to implement this philosophy, today I'd like to share with you a sneak preview of three new department initiatives to encourage the safe testing and deployment of drones. This will help communities reap the considerable economic benefits of this growing industry and help our country remain a global technology leader. So first, at long last, the department is ready to issue for comment a proposed new rule that will allow drones to fly at night and over the heads of people without waivers if certain conditions are met. And as you know, current FAA regulations do not permit small drones to fly at night without a waiver. The proposed rule allows drones to fly at night without a waiver if the operator has received appropriate training, completed approved testing, and if the drone is equipped with anti-collision lighting. In addition, current FAA regulations prohibit drone flights over the heads of people. This proposed rule will allow drones to make routine flights over people without a waiver or an exemption under certain circumstances. And these conditions depend upon the level of risk to people on the ground and are spelled out clearly in the proposal. This proposal will be published in the Federal Register as soon as possible. And your feedback is really welcomed. The comment period will remain open for 60 days after publication. And in the meantime, you can find the text at www.faa.gov. Let me also note that the department is keenly aware that there are legitimate public concerns about drones concerning safety, security, and privacy. And certainly recent events overseas have underscored these concerns about the potential for drones to disrupt aviation and the national airspace. So along with this new proposed rule, the department is finishing up two other proposals to address drone safety and national security. So the second proposal is the UAS Safe and Secure ANPRM, advanced notice of proposed rulemaking. This new proposal will identify major drone safety and security issues that may pose a threat to other aircrafts, to people on the ground, or to national security. And it asks for consideration, recommendations to reduce these risks as drones are integrated into our national airspace. Again, this is going to be published in the National Register, the Federal Register, as soon as possible. Comments and recommendations are really welcome. And the proposal will remain open for comment for 60 days as well after publication in the Register. And in the meantime, the text for this second proposal can also be found at www.faa.gov. Today's third announcement is the selection of commercial space entities that would develop technology to manage the airspace for the drone pilot projects announced in late 2018. As you may recall, the department selected 10 pilot projects from around the country to test the safe operation of drones in a variety of conditions currently prohibited by law. And today, the department is announcing three contracts have been awarded to commercial space service entities, to develop technology to provide flight planning, communications, separation, and weather services for these drones, which will operate under 400 feet. So the unmanned aircraft traffic management system will be separate from, but complementary to, the traditional FAA air traffic management system. It will create a shared information network and gather data that can be used for future rulemakings as well. And again, you can find out more at www.faa.gov. So taken together, these three initiatives will be a major step forward in enabling the safe, let me emphasize again, the safe development, testing, and deployment of drones in our country. And as we prepare for these exciting new developments in aviation, the department is updating its approach to two other key technologies as well, autonomous vehicles and commercial space. The department's approach to regulating autonomous or self-driving vehicles stresses collaboration and cooperation. In fact, the department's two guiding documents, Automated Driving Systems 2.0 and the updated Automated Vehicles 3.0, were developed through stakeholder engagements. We need that engagement, and we ask for that engagement. And I'm really pleased to note that 9 manufacturers have released their voluntary safety self-assessments, which are linked to the department's website for the public to read. So the department really applauds this transparency and encourages others to do the same as well. The potential of this technology to increase safety is especially noteworthy because more than 37,000 lives were lost on our roads and highways in 2017 alone. And yet the promise of automated vehicles will never be realized if the public does not have confidence in the safety, security, and privacy of their technology. So manufacturers and Silicon Valley must step up and help educate consumers about these new technologies. The public may not understand that automated vehicles have to meet the same safety requirements as vehicles driven by a person. In fact, there already is a federal safety framework for automated vehicles. And unlike aircrafts, automobile manufacturers do not have to get pre-approval from the government for every new part, so long as, and this is important, as so long as they meet the current safety requirements. So spending on innovation is strong in the billions of dollars. With these rapid developments, however, it is more important than ever that automated vehicle manufacturers put safety first and embrace transparency, which will build ultimately much needed consumer acceptance and trust. Because I have always said the constraints to growth in this industry will be consumer acceptance. Finally, let me also touch upon another exciting area of innovation, and that's commercial space. Here again, an update of the department's regulatory approach was long overdue. As directed by the Vice President's Space Council, the department is on track to publish a complete overhaul of its regulations regarding commercial space launches by February of this year. And again, this rulemaking replaces, you know, prescriptive requirements with performance-based criteria. And among other things, it will consolidate and revise all launch and re-entry licensing activities into a single regulation. to streamline the process while protecting public safety and national security. And three, enable flexible timeframes. Redefine when launches begin and allow the space industry to seek a license to launch them from multiple sites. The goal is to simplify licensing of launch and re-entry activities, enable novel operations, and increase savings to make our country's commercial space industry even more competitive. As all these proposals demonstrate, we're facing a new world in which technology is not easily siloed. Autonomous technology, for example, has applications across many modes of transportation. So the department is preparing for the future by adjusting, reforming the way that we work to reflect this new reality. We'll have an exciting announcement about this soon. I've given you enough today, but there's still another exciting announcement soon, so stay tuned. And let me emphasize again that in everything we do, safety will always remain number one. Let me close by noting that innovation is a powerful driver that creates new industries, new jobs, and changes society in ways that its creators could never imagine. I look forward to continuing to work with you all and all stakeholders on the issues that come with new technologies to advance safety, mobility, economic growth, and to ensure that our country remains a global leader in transportation innovation. I want to thank you all so much for what you do on a daily basis to keep our country safe, to keep our transportation system safe, so that our loved ones, our neighbors, passengers, drivers, our fellow citizens and residents can get from one place to another safely and be reunited with their loved ones. Thank you so much for what you do. Appreciate it very much. Thank you.
Talking Transportation, T-Talk Videos on Transportation TV.